And we're back with game number one in this round of 64 matchup between SK and Drinking Boys. We're going to be into our bands here, but we may as well introduce ourselves. I'm Pythian, hoping that you're going to enjoy this match with me. As we're in the epicenter, epic enter, Moscow Dota 2 tournament, North America qualifiers. Like we said, this is the round of 64. This is going to be the last match of the day for both of these teams, regardless of what happens. The round of 32 will happen tomorrow, and that is the last best of one series set in this tournament. Once we get to the round of 16, we will have best of threes. So we'll be looking forward to that tomorrow. I will be coming at you with some Southeast Asia games whenever those are happening. I'm still trying to get a handle of it on that. Not really sure how to read certain things, but in any case, we're going to be focusing on this match right now. We've got the Nature's Prophet already banned out by SK, and the OD going to be taken out by Drinking Boys.
Radiant team banned.
Not a whole lot to say right now, as we're going rather slow through these first couple of bans, the Lone Druid and the Faceless Void getting banned out. A couple, just, you know, these heroes that you don't want to see, you don't want to see your best of one dreams really ending against. Just the heroes that you as a team just do not want to see in your matches. So that'll bring us to the first couple of picks here. One of the people on SK, their name is I Am Peruvian America Stupid, so we'll see if this is this SK team is like Peruvian or something, or if they play a little bit, you know, differently from that. I'm not going to say better, because that's a little bit racist, but if they have a different play style than that, like less trolly, stuff like that. Not racist. It's not me. We do see the Earth Spirit and Death Prophet getting picked up by Drinking Boys, and the Invoker is going to be playing for the side of SK. A couple of really scary heroes getting picked up already. The Invoker, not really the threat that he used to be early in 6.86, but he is still a threat, and it's definitely something you're going to need to deal with eventually.
10 seconds remaining.
So they're going to pick up their second hero here. The Earth Spirit and the Death Prophet, scary for a different reason. The Death Prophet just dominates the lane, maybe not so much against an Invoker, but that Spirit Siphon, just that life suck that she has. It's ridiculous. It goes through BKB. It has percentage damage. That scales. It's good. I mean, that's really scary. I do not want to go against a Death Prophet IRL. Actually, I feel like that might have been my last girlfriend. Anyway, TLDR, Death Prophet, strong. The Earth Spirit, strong for other reasons, just has a lot of control and mobility. Just really interrupts these team fights and is very good. The silence is so long if he can hit it. So the main thing about the Earth Spirit is you got to hit those spells, and it used to be very easy to play him. It's gotten a little bit harder, but you know the skill of the players catches up with it, and Earth Spirit now one of the most sought after heroes once again, after he was put into captain's mode for the first time. In fact, it was the most banned out hero at Shanghai. After long deliberation, it is going to be the Lion that gets picked up by SK. This is a support that we see very often. And, well, they're very strong. I mean, we saw the difference between him and Shadow Shaman in the last match. Shadow Shaman good at pushing, but he didn't really even get to level 6. He dropped the snakes once in his base, and that was it. The Lion is a bit stronger. You can be a little bit far forward with your team. He had that nice draw aura to help him out last game. We'll see if he gets it this time. Radiant team. They are going to ban out the Sven. It's a hero that we've seen a lot more of. It's kind of a nice thing to see new heroes. And the Sven is one of those more fun ones to see. He just has so much damage. He turns red and then he obliterates you. And, well, it is fun to see people just kind of exploding sometimes. 5 seconds remaining. I think I'll turn down my sensitivity a little bit. All right, that should be good. Dire team ban. All right, and the Night Stalker is going to get banned out. I mean, these teams are taking quite long with their draft. It is good to think about things a little bit, but it's almost like they're really feeling out their opponent, which could be a good thing. There might be a lot of mind games being played here. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. The Darkseer gets banned out by the Dire. It's a pretty strong offlaner. I don't see a whole lot from Drinking Boys that's really going to play into that so far. So maybe it's something that they just don't want to go up against later. It can screw around with Earth Spirit's initiation a little bit in the fights with the Vacuum and the Wall. Kind of make him take a lot of damage. You may have guessed, I'm not the best draft analyst, but when we get into the game, things get a little bit more fun for me. I get to really just say some more random stuff that makes some sense. There's not really a whole lot going on during the draft, and it's a little bit more difficult for me without a co-caster to do it. But you know what? We're just going to press on, have a little bit of fun here. We do see the Slark getting banned out by Drinking Boys. So maybe they know something a little bit about SK. Slark is one of those flavor pickups that can do really well if you have an experienced player on it. And if you get a good start on him, he can snowball and be very hard to counter. Especially with the current lineup of Drinking Boys, it would probably be pretty difficult unless you can land that Death Prophet Silence to deal with the Slark. So instead, Beastmaster can be the pickup by Sane Killers. Dire team pick. And you've got a near-immediate Batrider from Drinking Boys. You are running low on the reserve time here for the Dire. So they have to be slightly quick with their picks. Get a little bit less time to think about it, but maybe they're pretty set by now. In terms of lineup, the Dire, they have some pretty good team fights, and they're not so reliant on cooldowns. The Death Prophet, that's one of the biggest problems with her. You're really, once you have the Exorcism, you can fight, but if you don't, you kind of got to wait a little bit. And now the Dire are going to pick up a Doom. I did see a little bit of Doom play earlier. It was not going well, so maybe they can make it go a little bit better this time. He is very tanky. He is of the run at you sort. 10 seconds remaining. And it is going to be your safe lane farmer. So maybe he figures if he can just get the initiation onto the Radiant with the Doom, or maybe just interrupt the Earth Spirit, he could do a little bit better in these fights. I do like how Drinking Boys, they picked up the Vengeful Spirit and then the Batrider, because a lot of the time you see Vengeful Spirit being used as a counter to the Batrider. There are some other heroes that can do the same role, like I would think the Oracle comes to mind there. It's definitely a big counter to the Batrider, but we haven't seen so much Oracle lately. But definitely good to kind of make a block pick there for the Batrider, just making sure that you get the full utility out of that hero. 5 seconds remaining. Oh, the Orsa Bear. That makes me sad. I love Orsa. But he's going to get banned out by SK. I do kind of see the use of him kind of just clean up a couple of the heroes on SK. But one of the things that I hate the most is having to play an Ursa against Invoker. Just if you're going Quas Wex against an Ursa, it basically shuts him down. It's so difficult for him to do anything. It's so easily kited. So maybe this isn't going to be a Quas Wex Invoker. Maybe it's going to be QE. I'm not sure. Maybe it could be. Maybe it won't be. Only time will tell. But with that being said, we're going to be going into our last couple of picks here for the team. Only 2 seconds of reserve time here for SK. And we do have substantially more here for Drinking Boys. Pretty soon we're going to be getting into this match. We're waiting for the carry hero, I would think, for Drinking Boys. And SK, they probably need another support. Which makes it interesting that the Juggernaut was banned out. Maybe they anticipate a Doom Jungle. It could be a thing. I definitely don't want to see a Doom being a safe lane farmer. I don't think that's strong at all. So having him go jungle kind of makes sense. The Phantom Lancer is a pickup for Drinking Boys. A good early hero kind of complements that Exorcism of Death Prophet. Just kind of run at people, keep them away from towers, be a threat, really. You do have to be careful of the Doom, though. If he can get that on you, and it does constant damage over time. They always know which one you are. They can finger you. They can spike you. They can roar at you. They can basically violate you in any way possible. So you do have to be careful of that. The Spectre is going to be the last pickup from SK. And, well, we could have a bit of a long game on our hands here. It'll definitely depend on how the lanes go and how the mid game goes. But if we get through that mid game, we could be in for the long haul. So let's just strap in tight and get ready for this match of Dota 2 between Drinking Boys and SK. Alright, we're going to hop right into this match here. I'm going to put up the last hits for you. I'm going to introduce our teams. Here for the Radiant, we've got, for Drinking Boys, on the Death Prophet, Getova S. Sakula will be handling the Phantom Lens with lasers in his eyes. We've got Shanks on the Earth Spirit, the classic XD on the Vengeful Spirit, and the Batrider is going to get handled by Chinese character. He's got a pretty cool set there. Meanwhile, for the Dire, we've got Hebelius on the Invoker. The Doom will be played by Guz Mantua. Hank on the Lion's got an eye in the middle of his forehead. They call him Three Eyes. We've got Kurosaki on the Beastmaster. And finally, on the Spectre, going to take this game late, possibly, is going to be Dark NS. They're going to head over towards the bot rune. And surprise, surprise, the Radiant are hanging around here too. Got Death Prophet just running around. Maybe the Radiant are just going to decide they don't want to take the level 1 engagement. They want to go top. So they're not going to contest at the rune. They don't trust their level 1 as much as the Dire. Which makes sense. I mean, the Lion, pretty strong. And especially with the Invoker at level 1. The Invoker hasn't actually gone for anything. But with the additional vision gained from the Hawk, that's probably not something you want to engage into. The battle begins. So Hebelius with the Invoker going to go Wex first, and he's going to pick up the first rune, and you've got some deep wards going in. Got a Sentry Ward, or maybe just a Doom just going in deep. Got the Devourer. Oh man, that Courier already, but he just walks right past it, goes underneath the tower a little bit, takes a tower shot for his trouble. The Invoker's getting harassed out by the Spirit Siphon, taking a lot of harass for this, but the Death Prophet might just get as much as well. Oh, Doom's going for it again, but he's already shown himself there. The EMP just zoning off the Death Prophet from the lane a little bit, and this Batrider could be in trouble. He's gone for the Sticky Napalm first, and with two stacks onto the characters on the top lane, they might want to be a little bit careful. No stacks anymore on the Spectre, so she could go in on this, and just a lot of harassment going on over the map. The Classic goes in against the Beastmaster, and he's trying to chase her down, has that slow from the boar, but meanwhile, we do have the roll on the mid lane by the Earth Spirit. Nothing much doing by the Death Prophet, though. Doesn't really want any part of that. Oh, just sets up that list for the Death Prophet. So nice. And Vengeful Spirit just continues to be a nuisance to this Beastmaster. And look, he's hardly even harassing him out. He doesn't have the axes, so she doesn't even have to worry about him at all. Yep, and she's at full health. He's at none, pretty much. And he just goes right back up the hill. She has a stun available. She's going to use it. This could be our first blood. She walks up again. Is she going to be keeping the vision? No, she's going to have to go under the tower for this one. And there's the cold snap. She could be the turnaround here. The board gets summoned, and the tornado going to miss. She jukes over to the north, and does the invoker know about it? Oh, she could be out. No, the invoker takes another route around, and she's going to run back into him. She's going to try to get the deny. Uses the fairy fire, goes over to the ancients. Is she just going to try to run away? There's another cold snap. She's in trouble. But oh, wow, the Bat Rider gets the first blood on top lane as we're looking at this one. Just so much time. And the Bat Rider is able to get it onto the line. So, well, T tours it up. The first blood goes to top. And in the end, the kill did end up going to the Invoker, but he spent so much time going for that. Look at this level difference on the mid lane. We've got level 4 Death Prophet and level 3 Invoker. That's a lot of time wasted by your Vengeful Spirit, and that's a job well done there. Another Spirit Siphon going to get used. There's the stun and the Crypt Swarm doing a lot of damage to the Invoker. He's Fairy Fire! It doesn't matter. He goes down anyway. Oh, so close. And meanwhile, on the top lane, we've got Spectre taking a lot of damage. You've got the Napalm on your head and the fire burning your butt. That's a 2-kill across the map. And Batrider's looking pretty good. He got the first blood and he got a second kill onto the Spectre. So that is your carry going down. And that's definitely not what you want if you're SK trying to win this match. Drinking Boys looking pretty good right now, and they've got no answer for this Vengeful Spirit. She just wants all of this Beastmaster. He's got the Hawk scouting up right now, but look how low he is. He does not want to stick around here. And Vengeful Spirit knows about it. She's got the Haste Rune, and she could go in from behind here. Beastmaster backing up. She doesn't have vision. Is she going to be able to get this? She has the stun available. Oh, man. He is in and out of vision right now. And Vengeful Spirit, you're going to have the Haste Rune running out. And the Beastmaster just sitting there, not looking pretty good. I don't even know if there are any TPs here that could come in to help out the Beastmaster. Sakura, level 5 right now, going to take out the boar. They have vision. There's the courier. Are they going to be able to get it? One hit in by the Phantom Lance, and oh no. Just too far away from for this Vengeful Spirit. Now the Beastmaster going to salve up, and that's going to be a bit of a wasted opportunity here for the Vengeful Spirit. She was doing so well putting the pressure on, but unfortunately wasn't able to capitalize on anything. Almost level 6 Death Prophet will get it from this Bounty Rune. And that could be the push. And this Invoker still only less than level 5. Now they call that level 4. But in any case, just Death Prophet winning this lane so hard. And the Doom rotates over to the mid lane. He is level 2 right now, and he's got a regen aura. That's not a whole lot. You've got the Bat Rider just being aggressive on the top lane. Almost level 6. He's going to get it soon. He could Firefly these creeps, and he's just going to force the Spectre to kind of tank all these Radiant creeps. And that's not what you want to do as a Spectre, especially when you don't have any kind of shield. Yeah, that's difficult to deal with. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, we've got Beastmaster taking a lot of damage. There is going to be a TP in by the Doom, but he might not want to be here. He could take a lot of damage from this, but he's just going to soak up some XP. So that's good for him. He'll get a chance at like level 3, a little bit closer to the Doom. He'll get some last hits, actually giving it over to the Beastmaster boar right there. But still, the Doom gets a couple of levels from this. I guess what was stopping them from going in further there was the Phantom Lancer being so low on health. Death Prophet continues to dominate this mid lane. Now look at top. Earth Spirit just eyeing down the... Well, he doesn't see the lion right there, but he's just eyeing down the Spectre here. He's waving stuff, canceling stuff. And there's going to be the stone in, and the Batrider just rides right over it. There is going to be a stun coming through. They could go for two here, but no. Batrider's just going to secure the Spectre. And the Spectre goes down. Not even a Lasso being used. Invoker finds the Haste Rune. And we could see something going on in the mid lane. Doom's here. He's got a stun on the sword, but I still don't understand why he's rotating around so much. It's not effective at all, and his time is just better spent in the jungle. And it's not like even they're contesting him too much at all. Hank could get a nice stun here if he tries, but oh man, he just splits the uprights. Hank staying alive, and Batrider uses a Firefly, has that lasso available. The Spectre a little bit smart there. Here comes the Doom, has a stun available. Batrider low on health. He's got to be careful. He could go in on Doom. He's got the lasso available. The Firefly's about to run out soon. There's the lasso. There's two stacks of the napalm onto the Doom. He's standing inside the fire. Spectre's putting the damage onto the Batrider. Meanwhile, on the backside. Oh, Invoker comes through. Are they going to be able to get the Batrider? No, he's just going to be able to run away. EMP on the backside. Shanks taking a lot of damage. He will, in the end, go down to the Doom. That's giving him a couple of levels here. And me on the bottom lane, just so much aggression across the map. Here's the Doppelganger and the Phantom Lance onto the Beastmaster. He's just so dead right now, not having a good day at all, just waking up and saying, man, I really wish I could just not be dead 90% of my life. 6 kills to 2, big advantage here for DKB, Drinking Boys. Forgot their name for a second. Oh well, I should probably learn it sometime. Maybe at the end of this match, I will know their name. Batrider pretty close to a Blink Dagger. And we have a rotation on that mid lane, putting the ward down. Nice and behind the tower. Oh, but it's quickly dewarded. Nice awareness of the... Oh, he got the last hit on the ward. It was a bit in question there, but at least the Doom got it in the end.
Dire's bottom tower.
And I'm a little bit surprised this mid tower hasn't taken more damage. Okay, well, that makes a bit more sense. The Death Prophet hasn't gone for an exorcism at all. It's not as effective at level 1 as it used to be, with the witchcraft being taken off of it. But it's interesting that she hasn't decided to level at all. Spirit Siphon and the Crypt Swarm are extremely strong spells, so I understand it. It's just... interesting that with the amount of dominance that they have, they wouldn't want to go for the tower. Being a little bit aggressive here on the mid lane, as the bot tower was taken by the Phantom Lancer, with not a whole lot of help from anybody else. And this Batrider, there's the Blink Dagger, and... well, he is right underneath a Dire Observer, and he has it in his inventory. So they could have possibly scouted out if they wanted to. Not sure if they did. They weren't pinging it out at all. That could possibly mean that they don't know about it. Death Prophet just going underneath the tower for no reason. Just asserting the dominance. Not too much of a deal right there. And wow, these Phantom Lancer illusion is pretty far in there. Okay, Batrider, Blink, Lasso, easy kill on the Invoker. He does use the Tornado, but he's not able to get the Ghost Walk off fast enough. And he eventually goes down, with the first lasso being used in a good smoke and a blink used by the Batrider. And there is the level 9 Exorcism. Gonna get used on that tier 1 tower. The creeps are taking a lot of damage, and there is a little bit of a rotation here by the Doom. We'll see if he's able to stop the damage coming out on this tower, but they are just going to clear the creeps. The Death Prophet's out of mana, so she's not going to be able to Crypt Swarm these creeps down, and she is taking a lot of damage from them. The TP comes in by the line, and the Invoker's up in just 1 second. They do have to be careful here. There's a net onto the Death Prophet. Nice net by the Doom. And there is a finger on the Death Prophet. Just so much damage there. EMP is going to get used onto the Batrider and the Haunt as well. The Doom gets low. They might go for the... yeah, they go for the Spectre. The Spectre just haunting in. Got the kill, but you're not going to get anything else. That was a dominating streak going down. So I think they do still get the... yeah, they still get a big advantage with that 1,700 gold, but you do not want to be losing your Spectre this early in the game. I mean, you've already lost it 3 times. That's not a good day. It was a dominating streak that you took. Or just kidding. You didn't even get the kill. You didn't even get the kill. I'm done with you. That's it. Earth Spirit has been kind of quiet. He's just hanging out for level 6 right here. He's going to get it with this last creep, only 4 XP. He actually misses the last hit because he's a scrub. But sorry, I'm hitting hard, I know. Here comes the Invoker. Tornado EMP combo and a Doom. done keeping... Oh, wow. He uses the Doom for that as well. So not even going to let him get a chance to get out of here. And they will smack him, swipe him, just magic his face down, melt it off. That's 700 gold. That's a lot of gold. The tier 1 tower is still up. 35 seconds left on the exorcism. Tower is rather low. Lion misses the... Well, he doesn't hit the stun onto the Death Prophet at least. And well, a little bit of scouting being done here. Batrider has a lasso available, but he's not going to... He knows that Doom is down. But he doesn't have a whole lot of help from his team. So he does have to be a little bit careful here. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, you still got the tower being pushed. Invoker has joined the fight. He's got the Tornado EMP. And a nice life suck getting used onto the Invoker, just dying, burning down the fire. And they take a tier 1 tower for their troubles along with the kill on the Invoker, and they immediately smoke up and Phantom Lancer TP's over to top. And the Spectre just running around here. Could get caught out by the Batrider. There's a stone in. You could call it a stone's throw, but I prefer to call it a stone's roll, as they roll to that one and Earth Spirit gets a kill on the Spectre. 4 deaths for the Spectre, just not looking good at all right now.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Death Prophet takes a kill on the tower there, and that is me not changing over to the net worth. Wow. Sometimes. Gotta get on my game, boys. Death Prophet just continuing to push in here. She's almost at level 11 where she'll get that level 2 exorcism, and she's just trying to clear out these creeps. Now she has it. And she's left the rest of her team just pushing in the mid lane. Sounding like a dog here. Should probably go get a drink sometime. In any case, Phantom Lancer has completed those boots of travel. And the Death Prophet going towards the Yule Scepter after building up those boots. I mean, sorry, drums. She's got boots and drums. Boots and drums. I meant drums, though. And for the Dire in terms of items... Well, the roll's gonna miss. The kick's gonna miss. As I say that, it hits on the Beastmaster, so... I guess you've got a secondary hit on the kick. And Beastmaster is going to get lassoed up here. The Tornado's actually going to miss. The Doom gets used on the Death Prophet. She's not going to be able to use anything here. The Finger onto the Vengeful Spear takes her out. And now DKB a little bit far in here. They're going to get the kill onto the Invoker, but they just have... Okay, here's the Phantom Lancer. Big Cat Man. And he's going to try to do as much work as he can here. We'll see if he's able to find anything. He has a doppelganger, but he's not going to go forward. He's scared of the line. They're just going to settle for the Doom. And he's going to try to TP out. Canceled by the flame break. And in the end, that's going to be a 3-for-3. With the advantage going to SK, but at least Drinking Boys, they got something out of it. And for the Phantom Lancer, you got some gold. I mean, it's still a pretty big win for SK, but Drinking Boys just showing that they're still in this match. And the Phantom Lancer has a Yasha and Boots of Travel. So he's looking pretty good right now. The Batrider's finished up the Force Staff. And he's just farming up some creeps here. You will see a Medallion of Courage on the Vengeful Spirit. Mechanism on the Doom. This Invoker just has nothing. And there's a double damage rune in the river. Vengeful Spear being pretty aggressive here. She may have been scouted out by that rune. Ward, rather. There is going to be a Tornado EMP combo onto the Earth Spear. Could get swapped out, but he's just going to get turned into a fish. And Vengeful Spear walks right up, says, I'll take an Earth Spike to the face. And there's going to be damage coming out here from the Invoker. Phantom Lancer. I'm trying to help a little, but he's going to get netted up, and DKB, the classic, well, not looking pretty good right now. Going to get burned off by that urn. There's a lasso onto the Doom, onto the high ground. He's going to get kept there, and there's a Spirit Siphon. Life Suck being used. There's the yell, but the Death Prophet just doing more damage than she's taking right there, and that's how you win Dota. in the end, the Crypt Swarm takes out the Invoker, and on the backside, the Spectre killed the Phantom Lancer. Interesting turn of events right there. So I expect to see the Dire still winning these fights in terms of gold change. It was a 3-for-3 still, but the lead is changing. Like, the net worth is getting closer and closer together, so you're going to get less utility from these fights. And the push comes into the bottom lane. And they're going to have creeps here in a second. The Dire are responding, so you do have to be a little bit careful, but they're just going to clean up these creeps as fast as possible and let the creeps just push in to the tower.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
In terms of XP, 5,000 in favor of Drinking Boys, and net worth about 10,000. We'll call it 8,000. How about that? You did see the mechanism completed on the Doom. He doesn't have any mobility here. You just got the net, which is a pretty good pickup from him. Also, the Lion has his Blink Dagger, so they do have to be worried about his initiation. The Invoker's still working on some items. He's just not getting his gold up here. And the Spectre has Drums and a Blade of Alacrity. So still not looking very good. There's a Blink Lasso onto the Invoker. There's a nice sound being used onto the Lion. He's going to be in trouble. Stun gets used. Magic Missile onto the Invoker. Now Spectre going in from the backside. Does have to be careful. Invoker eventually takes enough damage to go down here, but the Doom onto the Death Prophet takes her out, and now Phantom Lancer trying to do the work onto the Doom. He is very tanky. The nice yell is going to make sure that the Phantom Lancer sticks there for a second, but doesn't matter. The triple kill by the Batrider, and they're trying to get out of this one. Oh no! Vengeful Spirit just runs right into that tornado and says, "I will die for you, friends!" You didn't really need to, but ended up happening anyway, and there's a lot of kills going on there, and the fit recap, not the most informative there. I want to say that was a buyback on the Invoker. No? Yeah, you did.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Shanks, invisible here, trying to get up to some hijinks, but he's going to walk underneath a sentry ward pretty soon, and there's the tornado EMP, and this is probably going to be a dead Earth Spirit. Yeah, just smacked down by the Beastmaster. Batrider on 2,000 gold right now, just keeping his farm up after getting that Blink Force combo. And he's sitting right underneath an Observer Ward right now, which is going to expire in about 20 seconds. But he definitely needs to be careful here. He doesn't know it, but they know exactly where he is. They really want to take him out too. They don't know who's behind him. He's going to use the Firefly and just take out some of these creeps here. Look at him getting slowed down by the boar though. He's like, oh my gosh, how is this a thing? Lion's going to get the Blink onto the high ground. Just puts a little bit of an auto attack into the Vengeful Spirit. Just says, hey girl. There is a Blink Dagger on the Beastmaster, not going for that first item, Necrobook. And while the Exorcism gets used, the EMP is there as well. She's going to use to dodge it. And now the Spectre haunts in. She has taken a lot of damage, but so has the Death Prophet. We'll see who outlasts the other. The Yell gets used onto the Death Prophet. He's going to go down, so there's no more Exorcism here. The kick is on point, and the Batrider Lasso is going to drag the Spectre back. There's a stun, and the Phantom Lens takes her out. Gold Snap onto the Vengeful Spear. She could get very low. It turns to night, and the Invoker's trying to get out. The Dust gets used. Shanks kicks him in. Hank throws down the Earth Spike, but he's going to get burned down by the fire here. He is trying to save his friend, but is he actually going to go down here? The Lion gets out. The Invoker doesn't. So in the end, his job was futile. The Beastmaster, just sad Beastmaster, getting chunked down by the Phantom Lancer illusions in the trees. And, well, that's a triple kill for Phantom Lancer. Oh, man, these fight recaps are just dropping the ball. But that's a big fight taken by Drinking Boys. And in addition, they're also going to work on getting this tier 2 in the bottom lane. Earthspike's going to miss onto the Batrider as he just leads the creeps on a merry little chase through their own side of the map. And the Phantom Lens for Illusions, well, they're not too interested in taking this tower down right now, actually. They probably could have stuck there with the Batrider being as aggressive as he was, but they decided not to, and the Tier 2 tower will stand to fight another day. 3,300 gold on the Batrider. We'll see what he decides to go for. I mean, maybe he just likes to have gold in his pockets. Nice D ward on the Sentry ward. Wow! What a support. A Batrider uses the Firefly. Has that blink available as well as the Force Staff. He's got to get out of here. Here's the Cold Snap. The Tornado's going to miss. And this... okay, there's a nice silence on the Beastmaster. It's going to stop him from doing the yell. The EMP is going to hit on only the Vengeful Spear, and that takes up all of her mana. Oh, but the Beastmaster eventually does go down to the Batrider. Wow. So we... at least the initiation hits, but they used a lot of resources for that, and now this poor Vengeful Spirit hardly has any mana. What a sad, sad day. There could be the initiation. There's a swap. No mana for the stun, though. On the backside, we've got Earth Spirit taking out the Lion. Life Suck getting used onto the Invoker, but that's also while there's a Doom onto the Death Prophet. This could be another death for her. Batrider doesn't have a lasso for another 30 seconds. This Vengeful Spirit, stunned up by the Doom, goes down there. And will they be able to find the Batrider? He's got a blink away, and yeah, he's just going to get out of here. So, big fight taken in their own jungle by SK with a couple of heroes down. It's a 2-for-1. There's a nice ward by the Doom. He could be going for some Guardian Greaves. He's got Mana Boots and the Mechanism. Interesting play by this Doom. I mean, he's kept this ensnare for most of the game. And it's been pretty good for his team, although sometimes he doesn't really have the mana to do everything. In fact, having a Mechanism on him, not sure if I agree with that, because he's already hurting for mana already. He's got a 200 mana Doom, a 150 mana net, a Devourer that he's got to use sometime. So you're already up to 310 mana. That's basically all that he has right now, and about 40% of your mana pool. And then you also have that Mechanism in there, which is 225. So that's basically all of it right there. I mean, it forces you to have that mana regen up. It is good for him to have the mana boot, but I think there are better carriers of a mech. Possibly the Lion. Although you definitely would have that Blink Dagger. I don't know. I just think the Doom is an awkward pick. I think there are better things than a Doom in this game. Death Prophet going for an Aether Lens. Not doing as well as she was in the beginning of the game. There's a Perseverance on your Invoker. That could possibly be building into a Lincoln Spear to play against the Batrider. I do like that pickup. But there is an Exorcism getting used. Death Prophet just taking out this mid-tier 2 tower. She's doing the damage. She's going to get the help of the Phantom Lancer. And the Dire tried to answer with some damage on the bot tier 1 tower. But that's only a Beastmaster. And the rest of the Dire, they're nowhere close. They may try to keep going in here. The Exorcism still has some duration left on it. But they could also back up and go for some other kind of objective. Batrider, he's got the lasso available. He could find out the Invoker. That would be quite a kill. But oh, the Tornado right there. He does end up getting the lasso off. And he gets turned into a fish. There's the Spectre Haunt. Nice yell onto the Batrider, but it's not on the Death Prophet like it usually is. The Doom also gets used onto the Earth Spirit, so he's not going to be able to do anything else. The Batrider already down, and this Spectre taking a lot of damage. This is not who you want to be losing in your fights. The Phantom Lancer, Doppelgang's up to the high ground, and the Doom, he's low, but he's not going to be going down this time. Yep, the Phantom Lancer just decided to move back. They are getting scattered out by the Hawk, but the Hawk's just going to go down. Hate for animals. Someone call ASPCA. The Vengeful Spirit just hanging out here. A little bit far forward, but that's okay. SK continues to take these fights while behind. The smoke is going to get used to get the Vengeful Spirit out of here. But the Invoker's still going for the chase. He's going to back up now. And eventually it dawned on him that his efforts were futile, and he may as well go back to peeling potatoes for his father. Man. There's a Necro Book being built by the Beastmaster right now. And eventually it's going to be upgraded more. We can take a look at the XP and gold. XP in favor of Drinking Boys still, and gold continues to move up, even if there are slight dips along the way. This Invoker, of course, going for that Lincoln Sphere. And the Spectre. We haven't really looked at her too much, but there's not a whole lot to look at. She does have a Manta Style, which is good against the Death Prophet and the Earth Spirit. But it's a little bit worrying about how much damage is going to be coming out. There's a smoke here by the Dire. And they're a little bit disagreeing on their path here. So now they're going to walk up here. Will they be able to find anything? The Phantom Lancer a little bit far forward. There is an illusion farming the camps. Are they going to? No, they decided not to. I'm not sure if they had vision there or not, but they do not initiate on the illusion, which is probably a good thing for them. They may about to know about the smoke. Vengeful Spirit breaks the smoke. Tanks the yell, though, and there is going to be a nice silence onto the Beastmaster. Doesn't really matter, though. He's already got the off and okay. Batrider just runs in. He gets doomed, though, and this is taking up a lot of the damage off of your Death Prophet. Phantom Lancer takes a Beastmaster off on the back of it. Death Prophet is taking a lot of damage. He gets turned into a fish, and Hank goes down. So does the Lion. Sakua. Sorry, Hank is the Lion, but the Death Prophet went down. Well, this is going to be a full five-man team wipe. Triple kill for your Spectre, and this will probably turn into a tower for the Dire. Looking pretty good in that fight. Just using the smoke to its full extent, taking the five-man wipe, and they'll turn this into a tower. Spectre, after that fight, has 2,600 gold. We'll see what she decides to build in now. Definitely has some more options after that fight, and the Guardian Greaves were finished on the Doom. As well as the Lincoln Sphere on Invoker. So this will be an easy tier 1 tower. Not last hit by the Spectre. She was trying so hard, but she wasn't able to get it in the end. And SK strike back. They are getting back into this match, doing pretty well right now. And they are getting those items left. You got the Blink Dagger on Doom. And the Batrider went for an Ags. So he can lasso two people now. I think there are better items than that. But now he can lasso two people. It's a bit of a gimmick, I think. We'll see how it works in the team fights. I hope it works for him. It will be interesting to see. I'm just a bit skeptical. Beastmaster has a Blink Dagger. Still level 1 Necro Book. I don't think he has level 2 yet. He is getting pretty close. About 150 gold away from that. Apparently my graphics processing unit needs another update to its software. Yay. The Spectre, 3,800 gold. Is this going to be a Radiance from her? Be interesting if she decides to go for it. It could be good against Drinking Boys' lineup, and actually, against the Blink Daggers, well, the Blink Dagger of the Batrider, it would be really good if you could just pop that haunt before the fight. I mean, you saw how the Batrider just kind of wandered along, really lost in the last team fight. He wasn't able to get the lasso off, and he didn't have his positioning items ready to go there. So things were very difficult for him. So if he ends up getting his Blink Dagger disabled, just things will get very difficult for him. Random dust, missed, but worth a try, I suppose, by the Earth Spear, who has picked up the Veil of Discord. So more magic damage capability, and the Sunstrike Scouts of Pit is actually going to miss, so they're not going to see anything out of this one. And that could leave the Roshan available for the Radiant to go for. Instead, they're going to push along the bot lane. Got your Aether Lens completed on the Death Prophet. And three heroes just ready to defend this tower, which is on its last legs. And the Phantom Lancer can always Boots of Travel in. He's also got 4,000 gold, so he can also go for another item. Oh, Blink Forward by the Batrider. He actually four-staffs back into the EMP, so the Radiant get forced back, and their ward is going to get dewarded. The creeps still do damage to the tower, but this will probably lead to a deny by the Dire. Or they're just going to stand there. Beastmaster says, "Hey guys! Hey guys! It's in deny range!" They're just going to ignore it for now, and let it live. They say, "We will spare you for a couple more moments." Phantom Lancer continues to farm. He's going for the Scotty build. Interesting. And there was a Necro 2 completed on the Beastmaster. So if we take a quick look at the XP and net worth now, XP nearly even, and the net worth took a large dip there after those couple of bad fights. Right now, it just seems the Radiant don't really know what their next move is. They really do need to get that Phantom Lancer stacked up. He's pretty close to getting the Scotty, which is 200 gold away from him. Though he won't have any buyback after that. Maybe a buyback isn't so important for his team, especially with their only one tower taken so far in the game. Maybe buyback isn't so important to this Phantom Lancer, but it can definitely allow you to secure the game if you use it in the right situation. Spectre continues to farm, almost at that heart. This will get very difficult for the Radiant to go through. She actually didn't end up going for the Radiant. She went for the heart. Keep her alive a little bit longer in these fights, and maybe she just has figured out that the Mantis style is enough damage for her to be able to make it through and kill all the heroes in these fights. We'll see. She'll just go over towards the top of the lane. The Radiant will group up here. Looks like they're getting ready for a smoke. Or maybe they're just getting ready for a Phantom Lancer farm a little bit more. They ended up blocking the Ancients, I think. It's kind of inefficient, but whatever. The Scotty gets picked up by Phantom Lancer, and the rest of the Radiant, they probably should try to go for something now. The Batrider at 1800 gold. Maybe they want an item on him, but I don't think you need it. I think the main one is the Black King Bar on the Death Prophet. That might be what's holding up the Radiant right here. But that's going to allow the Spectre to buy up that Heart of Trask, which she does now. And your Invoker to get 2400 gold, and your Beastmaster to buy up that Necro 3. So lots of big items coming up from the Dire, and you might have a few coming from the Radiant now. And we'll see what ends up happening. 34 minutes in the game, and I said it right when we saw that Spectre picked. I said, we might be in for the long haul, boys, and it's starting to look like it now. Drinking Boys had by far the better start, but now with the Spectre on the Dire, they are coming back, and they could find a couple of pickoffs, and they could get right back into taking the reins on this match. Illusion. Radiant in a position not very familiar for them. They're forced to defend this mid-tier 1 tower. That's... what a reversal of roles here. Got a couple of illusions pushing him, but this Phantom Lancer just sitting in the trees. He ends up pushing it up enough for that tower to get taken. He TP's forward. That was a bit aggressive, especially with the line there. He didn't know anything about it. And, well, the Radiant, they're going to go into the Roshan. I don't think they're planning on taking it right now. They're just being a little bit aggressive, and while the Dire say, hey, we'll just back up if you don't mind. Especially with that Invoker Illusion in there, they don't really want to go in when the Dire have vision of it. There's a TP by the Batrider onto the top lane, but this Spectre has a heart. She's got a heart, and it's not too big of a heart to kill you, so you got to be careful. Chinese character man just clearing out the creeps. He's really farmed a lot. He's third on the net worth, which can be difficult to do as a Batrider, as you really just want to get the ganks, but he's managed to keep it up and do pretty well for his team. I don't really agree with the Aghanim's pickup, as you really haven't had any utility on it this match, but we'll see if he ends up just being a hero with it. We'll have to see, though. The jury's still out on that one. We might see an engagement here as a Batrider with the Firefly just flying above the trees here, trying to look for a pickoff, but the Invoker, he sees him, and he's going to back up with the Ghostwalk, just providing a lot of scouting for his team. And with 3,000 gold, he could provide a little bit more in these fights. Got to use the chapstick. All right, chapstick usage successful. And we're going to get right into casting, right back into casting this game. Push comes in by the Raiding onto that top tier 2 tower. Batrider ready with the Firefly in the trees, but the Dire, they're just not interested in this at all. I guess they're going for some kind of race to the towers, but the Exorcism is still available. It's level 3. They could continue to go forward. The Dire just... Okay, they're forced to TP back. But is this going to be fast enough? Here's the Exorcism. Going to get used on that tower, and it's already dropping fast. It's going to force out a Fortify. What's going on? The Invoker has a TP scroll, but he's not gone back just yet. This tower at half health? Is this even real? The Beastmaster takes out a tower in the mid lane. But look, the tier 3 is already gone. Oh, there's the Blink Blast. So it gets hit onto the Beastmaster, and he's going to get burned down by the fire. The Death Prophet uses the BKB, but there is a Doom on her. Lincoln Spear gets procced on the Spectre, and they may want to back up now. Just want to weigh off that Doom on Death Prophet. She gets healed up by the Ghost, and she's going to be fine. She's got 3,000 gold. We'll see if they decide to engage off of this. I think they might just back up, especially since the creep wave in the bottom lane is pushing in. So they pull back the Phantom Lancer, and they take a fight there. 1,400 gold change for them. Looking pretty good. They know exactly when to pull out, which is great. And they get the tier 3 tower for not a whole lot in return. So the Dire a bit on the back foot there. I'm not sure why they didn't go back to defend top a little bit faster. Maybe they don't really value tier 3 towers that much. But with the Death Prophet on the other team, with the Phantom Lancer on the other team, just opening up those racks can be rather dangerous. And you do have to be careful. You have to know exactly what you're in for. With the Spectre Haunt, though, you don't have to be as careful. Like, you can always haunt back and defend the tower. Possibly. We'll see. Depends how they play it. I mean, if you use the Haunt before that, that's not an option at all. Batrider uses the Firefly, just scouting it out here. Sees the Beastmaster, and he's got a creep, and the Beastmaster. I guess missing it doesn't really matter. That's why he built the eggs, so he doesn't have to worry about missing the lasso as much. And they end up getting the kill onto the Beastmaster, down for 75 seconds. It's a bit worrying. They go into the Roche Pit. Sakul, he wants an Aegis, and he's going to try to get it. He's at level 22 right now. Not level 2 anymore. That was 38 minutes ago. The Sunstrike is going to scout it out. They do have an Exorcism if they want to use it for this, but I don't think they do, especially with the Roshan very low already and the Dire with no position to be able to engage.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
The Aegis gets taken by the Death Prophet. Spectre continues to push on the top lane, uses a Mantis out, and in comes the Phantom Lancer. He blinks into the trees, uses a Doppelganger, and the Spectre is just going to TP right out. So a lot of... Actually, she's not even microwing the illusions there. I wonder what's up with that. Not very efficient. Well, the illusions went down. Death Prophet on 4,500 gold. These heroes just like to just hoard up that gold. They make their decisions on what to buy very late. And while the Earth Spirit rolls up to the high ground, got the Death Prophet close behind. And she's going to Crypt Swarm those creeps. Got another one in a couple of seconds. She actually misses the wave, the range creep, not turning far enough there. Oh well, she ends up getting all of them eventually. Beastmaster with the Necro 3 just trying to push out that mid lane. And they have no outer towers remaining. So he's not got a Necro book for this. That is not a good thing. Maybe he didn't anticipate a push coming through, but you have an Exorcism, you have a Phantom Lancer, and you have a naked set of racks here. There's the Exorcism getting used by the Death Prophet. And with an Aegis on her, you can just sit up there and not really have to worry about being doomed at all. They're going to give up this Rax. And Beastmaster with the Lincoln Sphere coming up. Tornado going to miss, but the EMP does not. Let's take a wide angle view as Death Prophet gets a lot of her mana stolen by that EMP. And she's going to suck off those little Forge Spheres, and the top melee Rax eventually goes down. And they are outie. They're just everybody out, full back. The bottom lane is pushing in. That's a big creep wave right there. And the Phantom Lancer says, hey, I'll go take that. But that's going to be the first Rax of the game here for the Drinking Boys. Took a little bit for them to get it. And if we look at the XP in favor of Drinking Boys by a little bit here. And net worth continues to grow after that little dip. 42 minutes in the game, exactly what we thought we were going to get with a Spectre in here. Just the Drinking Boys being very careful. They still have that Aegis, so they can continue to push here if they won, but they have to wait for that next exorcism timing. I would even think it could be a thing to just go up there with the Aegis without an exorcism, try to hit the tower tier 3. Maybe they've put out a lot of resources to take you down. If they don't, though, that's a bit of a problem. So maybe they put a lot of resources to take you down, then you just BKB, exorcism when you come right back up, and then you just smack them in the face. Say, hey, why are you focusing me? I have an Aegis. Tornado going to miss onto the Death Prophet. And she's just going to Crypt Swarm those creeps out. Oh, Batrider smoked up. He's going to blink forward. Get the Doom. This is a big target. And now the Doom in trouble. Going to go down. He has buyback. He has to use it. But the Lion, he's gone down as well. Phantom Lancer Illusions going up to the high ground. There is an Ice Wall going to stop the push there. And he's just going to save his Illusions and put him right back up the hill. And they're going to take a little bit of mana from the Invoker. The Radiant might be thinking about trying to split push here. The Exorcism, not used yet. The Tornado, gonna go through. Death Prophet gets slowed down, gonna keep Crypt Swarming. And now the Exorcism gets used. Goes to the high ground a little bit, continues to hit that tower. It will go down fairly soon, but she doesn't have any creeps here. They send in the Illusions, and they will end up taking that tower down. Here comes the Necro Creeps, though. The Silence is going to go in the Necro Creeps. On the backside, we've got Doom going on to the Earth Spear. He's going to get swapped out by the Ventral Spear. Phantom Lancer on the front side, trying to do quite a bit. The Death Prophet gets roared by the Beastmaster Inspector, trying to do as much as she can. But look, Kirasan Fan ends up going down to the Phantom Lancer. And now there's a lasso back by the Batrider. Ends up taking out the Lion. And now the Spectre, the lone remaining member. The Invoker forced to buy back, but it might not be enough. He uses a Sunstrike, basically hits on some illusions. And now the Spectre, in trouble, goes down, doesn't have buyback. Ultra kill for your Phantom Lancer, and, well, Ghost Walk away by your Invoker. They see him, and they're going to slow him down. He continues to walk past Flame Break back. And yeah, that's going to be a full five-man wipe, and a couple times over. Rampage for the Phantom Lancer. And they haven't GG'd out yet. They apparently think they're still in this. Big team fights, 5,800 gold for Drinking Boys, and they're making a pretty big case for getting into the round of 32 and into the second day of this online qualifier to something else. It's a little bit confusing. But the Mega Creeps, there's going to be a bid for it made here. The Death Prophet Exorcism's still down for about 15 seconds, but they're quickly taking down the set of racks, and, well, SK, they're just sitting in their base right now. Not really worried too much about those Mega Creeps, so they hit some creeps. Lasso back, and Phantom Lancer goes to work against the Doom, just making him hate life even more. That's Mega Creeps for DKB, and SK, not a whole lot of life left in this tournament. DKB shanks on the Earth Spirit, goes forward. There's an exorcism getting used. The Shiva's Guard going to try to get some vision into the base. A silence gets used onto the Beastmaster. And the Death Prophet takes the damage from the Necrobook. But here comes the Spectre. You might want to be careful here. She does have the Radiance now. And she's doing a lot of damage to the Death Prophet, who has the Octarine Core. It's pretty good. Shanks takes a little bit of damage from the base. And maybe you boys might want to go for the Ancient sometime, possibly. Finger gets used on the Death Prophet, but it doesn't matter. Hank gets a Death for his troubles, and there's a kick into the base. A goal! Our spirit gets a kick there, and there is a yell onto the Death Prophet. Beastmaster taking a lot of health damage for his troubles. The tier 4 towers are down, though, and the base taking damage pretty quickly. Yep, this is going to be in the end. Phantom Lantern gets tornadoed up, but it doesn't really matter. The creeps, they will do the job, and they will do the work. They will take the Ancient down, and Drinking Boys will take this victory in the round of 64 of the NA qualifier to the Epicenter Dota 2 event. I'm Pythian, and once again, thanks for watching, and as always, cheers. And I don't have my cursor. One. Got it.